Hello and welcome to another of MATLAB Helper's amazing videos on stock market with MATLAB. So in this video, we are going to see how we can design the UI for the stock prediction application. So we can begin our discussion by thinking of what elements we might need to build the UI, right? At the beginning, we'll need a drop-down menu from which the user can choose the companies that he wants to search. All right, now we need to let the user search the company because we need to find the historical stock price for a particular company. And this is because we need to have the historical data onto which we can actually fit the regression model, right? So that's why we're asking, or we actually need the drop-down menu into which we'll display the companies from which the user can choose one company. Apart from that, we'll also need one more drop-down menu from which the user can select the type of regression they want to do on the available data. Now we have given the user the option of selecting amongst linear, polynomial, and nonlinear. Now I have limited the options to these three options only. Now if you have the idea of more options, then I would encourage you to do so by adding more options in the list. You could have also had one more drop-down menu to allow the user to select options within these methods as well. For example, there are multiple nonlinear functions that one can fit onto a data, and we could have allowed the user to choose a particular type of nonlinear model as well as a particular type of algorithm to fit the nonlinear function onto the available data. I have omitted to use those extra features to make the application simpler enough for everyone to understand. Now, I've organized these two drop-down menus inside a panel so that the user knows that he needs to first choose between these two values. Then I have a button group here. Now, this is a radio button group, and only one of these three can be selected at a time. Handy because either of these three values is what we'll need for the user to choose from. First of all, we have the option for seeing the data. Now, this option will allow the user to visualize graphically the available data on the axis over here on the left. Now, for this case, for this instance, we are assuming that the user only wants to view the opening price versus the date. And this is because we have also assumed that we will be using the date as the independent variable and the opening price as a dependent variable in our regression. We are hoping that date will be a good enough variable to actually predict the opening price of some companies. After that, what we have done here is that we have included a button called Fit Data. Now, this Fit Data button is actually what will operate on the available data and fit a regression model from amongst these three options onto the available data. And finally, we have the option of clear access. Now, clear access is the default option here, and we can make any of these three as the default options by simply going into that button's properties and then checking on the value checkbox. Next, we have a panel inside which we have date picker. Now, this date picker will allow you to select the date on which he or she wants to find the stock price, the opening stock price of that particular company. Now, for those who are using MATLAB 2018A and earlier, they won't have the option of using a date picker. So what they can do is they can simply have three drop-down menus here instead of this, and have the first drop-down menu as the one to choose the day, the second to choose the month, and the third to choose the year. And this is very similar to what we did in the historical stock data application module 1. And that will allow you to actually do what I have done with just single date picker. Finally, we have this menu here, exit menu, inside which we have another menu called close application. Now, this menu will let us close the application once we have finished working on the application. It's all that we had on the UI. There are obviously multiple or many more features that you can include in this UI and make it more complex and more intuitive and interactive. I have omitted several of those features to let your imagination run wild, and so that you can work on this application as a foundation of your future applications. I hope that you like this video, and I await to see you in the next video.